In this part of the lecture, we're going to look at where polynomials come in play. Where are we using them? So the first thing we have to do is learn how to translate words into algebraic expressions and formulas. So for example, if I say twice a quantity, so a quantity, since we don't know what it is, you'll refer to that as a variable, and twice means multiply by 2. So 2x would be twice the quantity. You might be thinking to yourself, where nobody talks like that, but you actually will see things like that when you're working with certain geometric concepts. So this is a good example why algebra and geometry are not two separate, unrelated subjects. They are actually quite closely connected. Visualizing algebraic concepts using geometry is very useful, and similarly using algebra to do geometric problems also is very useful. So suppose I give you a rectangle with length L and width W, and I say find the perimeter of this rectangle. So since some of you may not even know what a perimeter is, let's just quickly review some of these geometric concepts. So perimeter means that you want to measure the length of what is all the way around the shape. So if you start with one unit like this, like a centimeter or an inch, you want to know how many of these green segments are going to fit around the whole thing. So let's just do this example here. So you have 1, 2, and 3. So 3 fit here. And if you are smart, immediately you'll realize, hey, wait a minute, I have 2 of those right here. So let's take and do that. So you know right away now that's 2 times 3 because you have 3 and another 3. So right away you have 2 of these. You also have to account for the vertical side. So here's 1 and here's 2. And you right away realize, oh, I can do that on the same on the other side. So I can do that here. Okay, so that will give you your perimeter. So it's going to be length plus length, width plus width. So 2 lengths, so 2 lengths plus 2 widths, or 2 times length plus width, is the perimeter of a rectangle. So you can see where twice the quantity comes into play. Twice the length plus twice the width added together gives you perimeter of a rectangle. So here's 2L plus 2W is a polynomial of degree what? Good. All right, let's do the area. Area accounts for how much space the shape occupies. And you always measure shape in unit squares. So if you have square centimeters or square inches. So if I wanted to have, say, square centimeters, I want to know how many of these fit in here. This is the unit square centimeter. This is 1 square centimeter. This is 2nd square centimeter, 3rd square centimeter, and this is another row of the same. So how do I find that? In the horizontal way, I had 3 of those times 2 of those. That's how many rectangular square centimeters fit into this rectangle. So the area of this rectangle would be what? 6 square centimeters, or this length here, which is 3 times 2. So 3 times 2, 6, and the square centimeter comes because that's the kind of square units that we filled the shape with. All right, so area of a rectangle is then the length times width. This is a degree 2 polynomial. So area of a rectangle is length times width, whereas perimeter of the rectangle is 2 times length plus 2 times width, or 2 times length plus width. What about squares? You know that squares are what? Length times width, but width and length are the same. So if you do L times L, remember our exponential notation, so that would be L squared, right? Let's just do some examples. If I ask you, what is the area and perimeter of this rectangle that has this property? Look at what's happening to the length and the width. Every time you are moving, the length is what? Twice the width. Can you see that? If you take this number and you do a computation, you can say, take that number, multiply by 2, and tell me what happens. You can see that that's 8.31, which is the same as that. And that's the same thing that will happen all the time. So how do I get a generic formula that will cover all of these rectangles? That is the wonderful part about having formulas with variables. It covers all types of shapes with the particular restrictions that you have placed on them. So we want to account for area and perimeter of this generic shape no matter what we do to the length. To account for a variable width, because the length is twice the width, we will have to get a formula. Why don't you pause the video here while you figure out how to account for that. So the perimeter, since we have our width, we'll have to represent by x. Why? Because we don't know what the width is. Depending on particular moment, it is this number. But what if I move it around? So if you don't know, you're going to have to label it as x. Then the width is x, so the length would have to be twice as much, because that's what we see the relationship happening here. So x and 2x are the dimensions of this rectangle that will account for no matter where I move this point D. So we have 2x and 2x, right? Twice that. And x. So added them together will give you 6x centimeters, since I'm measuring everything in centimeters. In terms of area, I would have to have 2x times x, and x times x is x squared. So 2x squared would be the area of this rectangle. So you can see we just accounted for how to get area of the rectangle based on the variable lengths. So there's an example of polynomials in use. All right, let's take a look at another example. Suppose I ask you to find area and perimeter of this shape. So go ahead, pause the video and go ahead and find area and perimeter of that shape. So to get the perimeter, you're just going to have to go around the shape. So you're going to start here, let's say. So you're going to have 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 2. So that was interesting to say all that at once. Anyway, so you add all that together and you'll end up with 22 units. Does that make sense? So you have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So you can always check. So once you have the perimeter now, let's see if you can do the area. So to do the area, you're going to have to be a little creative. So you're going to have to, for example, take and break it. So we'll say this will be a rectangle with 6 square units. This will be a rectangle here with 1 square unit. This will be a rectangle with 2 square units. And let's take this shape, and this rectangle will be 6 square units. And then you have one more 1 square units. So the total area would be 6 plus 6, 12, plus 1, 13, 14, 15, 16. So the area will be 16 square centimeters. Let's keep going more in translating word stuff. So we just did translating words from twice a quantity. There is other shapes that have twice the quantity appearing in them. If you look at circumference of a circle, circumference is the perimeter of a circle, and we refer to it as circumference. If you take a piece of string that is as wide as the diameter, diameter is twice as radius, right? So from here to here will be the diameter. And if you place the string around like that, you'll notice a little over 3 of diameters fit around the circle if you were to go around. People notice that the circumference to diameter ratio is always the same number, whether it's a small circle or a big circle. And that's why having circumference formula is 2 pi times radius. The pi is the ratio of diameter to circumference, and 2r is the diameter. So pi times the diameter of the circle is circumference of a circle. The area of a circle is given by pi r squared. In fact, if you're curious why this is the case, why area of a circle is pi r squared, then all you have to do is take a circle and cut it into small wedges. And the smaller the wedges, the better approximation you will get. And you will see when you can place them up and down like that, you will get a rectangle. with pi r as one length and r as the width. And so pi r times r, or pi r squared, is the area of a circle. All right, so again, this is a polynomial of degree 2. So 2 times pi times r is circumference of a circle. Let's take another example. So for example, if you look at a prism is like a cube where you have a base and then you have the same shape going up and down. So this is called a prism. It's made up of basically 6 rectangles. Can you see? Here's 1, here's 2, here's 3, and then you have a back, you have a side, and a top. So those are all the 6 faces of a prism, or a rectangular prism in this case. And so now to find the area of this, what would we have to do? We would have to take area of the base, which would be length times width. So that would be xy, but the top has the same area as the bottom. So that would be 2xy. If you look at the side here, the vertical height is z, and the width of that rectangle would be x. So this will be xz, and there'll be 2 of those, because you have this side and the one facing it. Then you also have this front. The front is going to be y times z, the area for that rectangle. And then there's also the back. So you're going to have 2 of those. So surface area of a rectangular prism is 2 times the bottom area plus 2 times the side area plus 2 times the front area. That will give you the surface area. Surface area is, if you had to wrap a box like this, how much material would you need? That's how you can think of surface area. Oh, let's go back. Also, what would be the volume of that? The volume of a rectangular box like that would be length times width times height. So x times y times z. So that would be a degree 3 polynomial. That would be the volume.